kind of got a bit of a temper, and she's one of those people who, if she's very defensive and feels, you know, if she's been at all sort of criticized or is going to be criticized, she'll be the first to beat to the punch. And she has this great line in the movie about why she and her husband are separating, and she just said, "I could tell he couldn't take it anymore, and so I cut him loose before he could do it to me." And that's sort of, that's Lila's philosophy on relationships. It was really thrilling for me to see this guy that 12 years ago was writing about, you know, giant cockroaches destroying the earth, and to read a script that he had written and was gonna get to direct that was so beautiful, so funny and spirited and charming and dysfunctional and sad all at once. And it was really thrilling to be asked to play a part that I don't generally get to play. So our parents, who divorced 10 years earlier, have to pretend for the weekend that they're still together. That misplaces our father's girlfriend, who is played by Susan Sarandon, and who has been like a mother to us for 10 years. And it's, you know, and comedy ensues in this ridiculous sort of caper that everyone's trying to pull off. That was another thing that was really exciting for me, is that when I loved it on the page, and then when Topher signed on to do the project, it was like, oh, this is going to be so fun and such a cakewalk, because he and I have just, you know, have a good banter anyway and have had a fun relationship anyway for years. And I just knew that I had such a so many scenes with him and so much sort of fun, that sort of witty, snarky banter with him. And I just knew we were going to have a great time doing it together, and that I would have my buddy with me on set, which is awesome. Justin has to at least 6 times a day probably, you know, tell us to shut up so that he can actually direct us or tell us what the scene's going to be or tell us what to expect. We've all become very friendly and very close very quickly, because we all have, you know, we're all sort of together all the time. There's so many big family scenes where you've got 8 people in the scene, so it becomes a social setting. So lots of joke telling, lots of laughter, lots of hanging out, and lots of talking even during takes. Maybe we should shut up more. They do everything wrong in this movie in terms of avoiding drama and avoiding the family kind of dysfunction when that starts to just, it always boils over during weddings. I don't know why. I think it's just stress, and you've got too many of them in one place together. It's just never a good idea. So my advice would be to keep everybody apart as long as possible. One rehearsal dinner and then the wedding the next day. That's it. No big group family dinners, no big picnics, no anything. Just keep everyone apart for as long as possible, because there's always going to be those tensions within big families that, you know, are going to explode under pressure.